Hey guys, a very happy Diwali to all of you. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. Since this is the occasion of Diwali, the most important festival of the Hindus, so I would like to say this to you that this may this Diwali bring to you a lot of happiness, a lot of prosperity, and everything that you wish to accomplish in your life, you will accomplish it. On that note, let's, on this occasion of the Festival of Lights, let's enlighten our minds with some of the important news that will enlighten you, that will inform you or aware you, I should say, about the current affairs, about the affairs that are going on in the world. And as we all know that on Diwali, we not only celebrate the Lakshmi, the goddess Lakshmi and the Lord Ganesha, but goddess Saraswati is also a part of the Trinity that we revere in the festival of Diwali. So why not do something to actually pay our tributes to the goddess Saraswati? So on that note, let's begin with our first question of the day. Which bank has partnered with Sunfresh Agro Industries Private Limited, the local branch of the global dairy major Lactalis, to extend financial support to the dairy farmers in Maharashtra? So basically, this partnership has been done with the bank in order to provide credit support to the small dairy farmers in the state of Maharashtra. So which bank is it? It is State Bank of India. Kyunki aaj tyohar hai, therefore I have brought to you very simple, basic and a limited set of questions in this video so that I would not consume a lot of your time. Okay, so State Bank of India has partnered with this organization, which is a local branch of this global dairy major brand Lactalis, which is based in France. Okay, so do remember this as well. Now, the basic purpose of this partnership is to provide support to the dairy farmers in the state of Maharashtra. Who has been appointed as a part-time chairman of Jan Small Finance Bank? So here the right answer is Subhash Thuntia, who was the former chairman of Insurance Regulatory Authority of India. Okay, Insurance Regulatory Development Authority of India, and he has now been appointed as the part-time chairman of Jana Small Finance Bank. Which bank has won the Top Organization with Innovative HR Practices Award at the 19th edition of the Asia Pacific HRM Congress? Canara Bank, Oriental Bank of Commerce, SBI, Karnataka Bank, PNB. So these are the five options. Out of these options, the bank that has won this award is Karnataka Bank. So guys, this award has been given to the bank for its innovative HR practices for human resource development and talent management. Now, the most important part here is that this award was given at the 19th Asia Pacific HRM Congress that was held at Bangalore. So do remember the venue of this Congress. What is the objective of the Har Ghar Dastak campaign? So here you have the five options: to increase financial inclusion, to enhance digital literacy, to spread awareness about digital financial frauds, to identify talented sports persons at the early age to make them Olympic ready, to increase the rate of vaccination. So which one is the right answer, guys? Here the right answer is option E, to increase the rate of vaccination. This Har Ghar Dastak campaign has been launched. So guys, can you now guess that which ministry has launched this campaign? Obviously it's the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare that has released this, launched this campaign. Now, this is the Union Minister. Name the person in the comment section below. What is the name of this person? Okay, so this Har Ghar Dastak, that is Knock Every Door campaign, aims to create awareness among the people about the vaccination, the second dose of corona vaccine. Okay, now this would be a month long door to door campaign, and as we can see that Bihar is one state that has the very low vaccination coverage at 39% for the first dose and 13% for the second dose. So So there are many areas, there are many states where the people have not been enrolled or have not vaccinated themselves because they have some kind of misconception. And still, it's the truth that people are dealing with the misconceptions regarding vaccination. And in order to spread awareness that no, vaccination is good for you, in actuality, it is going to help you in saving your lives. And as we can see that Corona is again coming up, it is again raising it head. Therefore, we all need to complete our vaccination dose. So those viewers of mine who have not taken their second dose of vaccination till now, if your date is not due, then obviously you cannot take it. But still, if your date is due, then do take your vaccination completely and take care of your health, because your health is also important for preparing and achieving the larger goal in your life. Okay, so often we talk about preparation of the examination, but preparation of one examination or any examination is not your complete life. That's just a part of your life. Okay, so don't take it as very serious, but at the same time, don't take it leniently. Okay, so you need to keep a balance between both of these things: achieving the goal, preparing hard for that goal, but at the same time, detach yourself from the obsession of one examination. Okay, because I have seen many students who prepare really hard for the examination, but unfortunately they would not clear the exam, and therefore they tend to go in depression, or there are certain things like that. So I don't want that to happen to my students. Therefore I'm saying that do not attach yourself to the level of obsession to your examination. Prepare for the exam for the sake of preparation, okay, not the sake of your life. Chaliye, so we have covered this news well, but do not forget to mention the name of this person in the comment section below. Next is, who has been appointed as the chairperson of the newly set up 20,000 crore National Bank for Financing Infrastructure and Development? So guys, this is the very famous development institution, the financial institution that has been announced in the union budget for financing the infrastructure projects. Now you have to pay attention to the corpus as well, because the corpus is very, very important. Now guys, before moving into the options and telling you the right answer of this question, I would like to ask you about the Swami Fund, because this was also a fund created by the Union Ministry of Finance for financing the real estate projects, the stalled real estate project that were not getting built up because of the lack of finance. So what is the total corpus of this fund? Because it is a fund announced in 2019. Can you tell me the exact corpus of this Swami Fund? And if you know the full form of this fund, then it would be very good for you if you tell me in the comment section. Okay, coming back to this question. So who has been appointed as a chairperson of this newly set up 20,000 crore National Bank for Financing Infrastructure and Development? The right answer here is K.V. Kamath. So as we have discussed that the purpose of this National Bank for Financing Infrastructure and Development is to finance the infrastructure development. Guys, we already have two very important schemes running currently for developing the infrastructure. First is the National Infrastructure Pipeline, that is the Gati Shakti plan. Next is National Monetization Monetization Plan. Now this aims to provide the government assets on lease, the government infrastructure assets on lease, and the money raised from that lease will be used to create infrastructure under the Gati Shakti plan. Okay, so my question from you is that the total corpus of Gati Shakti. Now this is very, very easy question for you, because everyone, I think, who is preparing for the examination has heard of this Gati Shakti plan or National Infrastructure Pipeline, and they know the exact corpus. So tell me in the comment section below, because I have given you a cakewalk question. So do mention it. So guys, here this session ends. A very happy Diwali to all of you again. Now I wish you prosperity and happiness in your life, and on that note I would like to end this session. Thank you so much. Enjoy your day, enjoy your festival.